to you today about what brings me on YouTube in the first place, which is the profoundly severe ME that I have experienced in my life, and which I'm starting to recover from, which seems pretty rare because I know a lot of people who are very ill right now, that they can't speak, they can't move in their bed, they can't swallow, they're on bedpans or diapers, feeding tubes. This is the kind of category I was in. At my worst, I was totally paralyzed except for my swallowing and my eyelids. I could open a couple times a day, so they did move, but it felt as if all the energy was just being sucked up into my main internal organs so that they had energy to function, like my heart and lungs, and there was nothing left. It started with my legs after I became severely hypoglycemic, and then in about 2 weeks it spread to my arms and my entire body. So I couldn't move for at least 9 months. I couldn't speak. I couldn't listen to someone say my name. I couldn't. It was very hard for me to have people in the room even sitting with me. I couldn't change my little tank top when the carer came for sometimes 2-3 months, because it was just so distressful, and I just didn't have the energy for that. So yeah, my bed stunk because we couldn't change the sheets. I stunk because I couldn't change my clothes or get a really proper wash, and the hair, forget it. No bed sink, it's way too hard. I couldn't have done that. I tried for a while and then I had to stop. It was just making me crash. So I lay there with my eyes shut. I couldn't conjure up a thought. I couldn't put 3 words together in my head. Although about once a day a thought would spontaneously arise. Like I would picture myself standing in a stream, or luckily it was something nice, but I couldn't think. So I also couldn't really think about what was happening, although my consciousness was very clear, and this is what really taught me, besides after my Buddhist studies, that consciousness and your brain they're not exactly the same thing. I was conscious of a lot of things happening, like when deaths would have occurred, but nobody would tell me. I later found out that they did happen, and you know, things like that I would see. It was more like pictures on a screen in my mind, and I would see them and I could process them, maybe because it wasn't something I was trying to do with my brain. I wasn't trying to think, I wasn't trying to take my heartbeat to see how fast it was, which I couldn't do even like with my ear and the pillow and looking at the clock and counting. I couldn't. That was way too hard. If the house was on fire, there's no way I could have dialed 911. I mean, I couldn't have moved, but even if I could have, I couldn't have. That would have been way beyond me. Even if the phone was right beside me, there's no way. So, I mean, many people nowadays are aware of Whitney Defoe, who's Ron Davis, and Janet Defoe's son, and who has been severely, profoundly ill, and they're familiar with that. I was like that, except I couldn't move except for swallowing, and he seems to be able to. I mean, he doesn't move around a lot, but he can sit up in his bed for a second or go like this. he doesn't seem paralyzed in the body, but he's paralyzed in swallowing and needs to get food via other methods than swallowing. So I'd say I was comparable to that. And I don't know of anyone who's come out of that state. Yet, except for me, and I was in bed for 12 years before I could even sit up and stand and then walk. So, you know, it's been a really long time. And what happened a year and a half or so ago, I was getting really desperate because I was hospitalized for being homeless, and then I had to get a home, which is a condo that is way too expensive for me, but you know, they want you at a hospital. So I got to the condo and the care was just not, the care was not reliable enough or good enough for someone as ill as I was, for someone who lived alone. So I just got to a point where I just thought, I have to do something crazy because I can't live like this. And that came along in the form of the masterfastsystem.com. It's basically grape juice activated with a bit of lemon juice, binders like charcoal, psyllium, and bentonite clay, and then some herbs. Now, when you do this fast, you kind of, it says on the website, you know, get ready for really big symptoms, or, you know, you have to be willing to give your life for this. And I was, because I was done. I had to try it. I didn't have a choice. I didn't have the luxury of being like, no, I'm okay the way I am. I'll just keep going. So I did it, expecting to not even really survive because my blood sugar is so fuzzy, and I just thought, just living on grape juice, that's not gonna help. And I did it, and with a lot of help from Gino, who runs a Facebook group and the website. And so thank you, Gino, for all your assistance there. I managed to do the fast for 72 days. I didn't have a number in my head when I started. I just said, I'm going until I feel better. And about 3 weeks in, I was lying in my hospital bed over there, and I thought, I can sit up now. I know I can. And I did. The next night, I thought, I can stand. So I got the walker, I got my carer to bring the walker over, and I stood. And from then, I slowly started taking steps. And Susan Free, my Feldenkrais practitioner, I think got my body ready for the steps, because it wasn't awkward. I mean, I relearned walking before in 2005 when I was in the hospital. That didn't last. And this was so much easier this time with the Feldenkrais. So thank you, Susan. And I would get to walking. I got up to walking 40 steps a night. I'd be at night because I had to sleep after. And so I would just, if you can see, I would walk around this island and go back to bed. So that was my big trip and my big exercise, my big new trick. And then I introduced eating again. I kind of changed my diet to a mucus lean vegan, so lots of fruit, vegetables, a bit of nuts and seeds. Sometimes I have little bit of grain or legume, but I feel better if I don't. All my blood work is fine, by the way, on that, and not deficient in anything. So with the Master Fast system, they say it is a 7 to 9 year commitment before you are completely healed. And I thought, okay, great, but I still, now I can maybe get to the fridge once if someone doesn't show up to help me, but I don't have 7 to 9 years, like, living even at this level of being able to get up once a day. So I kept looking for something I could add to the mucus lean diet that I was still keeping and the fast that I would do sometimes, you know, when the seasons change. And that's when I found this. See, I know it's backwards, so I'll keep it up for a while. And I started this in March 21st, I guess, of this year, yeah, 2018, and now it's October, so March, 7 months ago I started that, and now my life is different. What this entails is taking a catalyst via spray under the tongue, however your assistant tells you to do it, after you tell them your symptoms, your vitals. They keep tabs on you very closely. It's all done on the internet. It's not medical, so you can do it anywhere in the world. You know, it's not like getting stuck with not being able to see the doctors at Stanford, being in another country, because that's what's going to happen, and your doctor's not going to do what they recommend because doctors in other countries are too scared. So that's not really a viable solution for many people, is to go see Dr. Kaufman or Dr. Cheetah or the others at Stanford. It can also get quite expensive, $60,000-$70,000 a year if you're doing everything they say, plus testing, plus actual medicines. So this is much cheaper than that, and they say that between it takes to recover 1 to 2 years. So I'm on 7 months, and what I'm noticing now, like, look, I'm sitting up in a chair. I didn't do that before. I walk 400 to 700, maybe more steps a day, because I stopped counting, because I was counting my head, because the Fitbit wasn't really doing it properly. So I get out of bed, I move to the room in here, I hang out in here, I lie down, kind of semi-reclined against pillows, there's no hospital bed. I am having sleep difficulties, but even that's getting better. I managed to go to the dentist, with my dentist, for the first time since 2001, so it's 17 years. And I didn't crash when I had a cleaning, which is great. It's a really big deal. I haven't had a shower by myself. I would go out every day in the summer onto the balcony, and I'd wash up out there because it's sunny and you can splash water around. So, and I can get my own juice from the fridge or salad that's pre-made, whatever. I don't have to rely on the caregiver to keep me alive, because I was before, and that wasn't gonna work out. I'd be dead by now if I didn't start doing something that actually helped. So Yeah. What else can I do? Well, I kneel. I have a skateboard. Just kind of not too smart because I fall in a lot. But I like to stand on it and be like pulled around. It's good exercise for the core and the leg muscles. And yeah, life is livable. The days when I can't sleep, then I can't talk, and I can't see the day after, so that's kind of rough, but then that goes right away. I haven't crashed really hard like I used to for days and weeks and months. I don't do that anymore. If I get overstimulated or just feel like I've done too much, I do DNRS, and that will take it away and make me feel better. So yeah, the DNRS is also something important, brain retraining. I've been doing brain retraining in some form or another for years, and at the very beginning it did get my ability to listen to music back, watch TV back, use the computer, and that all happened within 3 days of my starting, and I was doing it 50 times a day, so something really switched there, and now I have a lot of other things that I have to do in a day, so I really try to get the brain retraining in there, but sometimes it doesn't quite make it. So, I have a wheelchair. I have a borrowed wheelchair, and I've been outside. I've been to the park. Yeah, someone has to push me there, but I can manage the movement of the chair and sitting in the chair, even though it's reclined with feet up. So it just opens your world up when you can go outside, and get your own food when you need food, so you don't have to always be feeling like everything is so scarce because you're not well enough to get it for yourself. And you know, that's not a life. So I just wanted to tell you what I was doing briefly and what it helped for me, and I'm going to continue with this, obviously, and I'll give another update in a while, but okay, I'll show you how I walk. See, I just got up with no assistance from a chair. Can open the door to my balcony myself, which is a really pretty heavy door. I can come over here, go to the fridge. Want the juice. Yeah, so obviously that's way different than just lying in this hospital bed and not even being able to have the head recline that much. So I've recovered a lot, and I want to keep on going. And if anything I've done could be helpful to someone else, I really want that, because this disease is just horrible. Okay, so thanks for watching. Be well, and I'll give an update. Maybe another 6 months or so.